Paul Lowok, the LC3 chairperson of Napunpun Sub-County, admitted and regretted that his vice chairperson was killed during the cattle raid in Apey Tolomo in Abim District. Lowok said the community was convinced to make Aped a leader whom they all knew was a notorious raider, thinking he would transform into a better person. He said the late had always warned both the security and political leaders to go back into raiding other than dying of hunger. After all, his animals were raided last year and none of them was recovered.
That they went to raid in a park. That is the story which you have heard. And two of them were killed in Lokodokodwe. I don't know if the cows are recovered. Me, I don't know, because me, since I was born, I never participated on raid. Since I left my school, I become a businessman up to date. Okay, I'm not accusing any security.
Peter Abraham Loki, the area member of parliament in GA County, condemned the act done by their fellow leader, blaming it on illiteracy. He said no literate leader can carry out such evil acts. He also blamed the security operatives for taking sides during the recovery process of raided animals and aiming at recovering only raided animals without guns when they follow up raiders, which has left the insecurity question unanswered. Loki called upon the government to provide a specific budget to tackle insecurity in Karamoja, other than having budgets only to cater for ministries' salaries.
The leaders who went to speak to the people, my chairman is there. And every person who took a gun was asking the brigade commander, after the gun, then what? I used personal money. I would give each of them 200,000 to say, go begin some small business, but as you wait for what government has planned for you. So to just have the UPDA praising themselves and forgetting that the leaders participated in the recovery of animals is not fair.
Faith Nakut, the woman member of parliament of Napark District, urged for counseling, caution and education of the Karachunas against raiding. She says these meetings will be of help to stop the insecurity in the region and the local leaders to know their role rather than getting involved in animal thefts and getting killed during the raids.
Fought themselves too hard until the disarmament exercise ended. And even when the disarmament exercise ended, they were the last to reconcile. But this place is known for bringing sustainable peace. The last meeting that happened here in Lopei between the people of Kotido de Gia community and the Bokora community, it brought peace to the entire region. The people of Napak accommodated the people of Kotido for 6 years. There was no single raid. Now when these insecurities spilled in, it became very difficult even to grade.
Meanwhile, veteran politician Professor Tarsis Kawejere has rooted for mindset change among the people of Karamoja at the height of insecurity in the region. Kawejere and other politicians have advised that what Karamoja needs now is not just military deployment, but massive sensitizations to stop killings. Security in Karamoja has significantly deteriorated at the hands of deadly armed cattle rustlers who have recently killed scores of people. Their resurgent attacks have steadily disrupted relative peace only achieved through successful disarmament enforced by government from 2003 to 2008.
Government can come in. People are talking of army here. Army cannot change a culture. The army comes in as an instrument of law and order. But the law and order in the mind must precede the law and order in society. Legal laws put in place don't help. They help when society can accept them. That's why the people risk their lives. They risk their lives in the cattle raiding. Cattle raiding is not a small matter. People that get killed. So we have to change the mindset. We have to change the mind. We have to change the culture. We have changed the focus.
On the question of redeployment of the UPDF in Karamoja, Kawejere had this to say. The
government has mobilized. They are talking now of more and more soldiers there. But the soldiers are going to be there. But when the mines don't change, we are going to have this problem coming and coming again and again. Because the government has been there. The government disarmed hundreds and hundreds of guns. Now the issue is, where are the new guns coming from? As people were talking on the radio, where are the guns coming from? They must be coming from somewhere.
One of the leaders in Karamoja region, Batom Dodot, said continued killings in the area have left so many people homeless. He rallied his fellow leaders in the area not to get tired of preaching peace. He also noted that education is still a challenge in the region.
80% of children of school going age in Karamoja don't go to school. They're in the crowds. And that is how they are recruited into warrior and criminality. So government needed to invest in compulsory and free education in Karamoja for about 10 to 15 years. And we need a budget of about 100 billion shillings for those 15 years.
To fully deal with the crisis, President Yoweri Museveni has pledged to redeploy the UPDF in Karamoja to ensure that peace prevails. Report by Agnes Najuma and Jaliat Namowaya for the news.